Horse World Expo in Pennsylvania. We're pretty happy because it is +5 degrees outside, which is a heck of a lot better than -14 in a snowstorm that we had to push through as we were heading south. Pretty excited. We've already got some team members that are down there and are getting the stalls ready for the horses. So this is going to be pretty big. This is going to be Arwin's first time doing some demos in a big, large ring. And I don't know what I'm going to share with you yet, but probably something good because it's going to be 4 days of awesomeness. So stay tuned and we'll see what's happening.
Yay!
We made it. The horses are all tucked in and now it is time for bed. Good night.
It is day one at the Horse World Expo. I've got trivia time here. The girls have taken the horses for a walk this morning. They've done their stalls. The rest of the crew is getting the booth ready. I figured out hopefully what the heck I'm doing for my various demos and performances. So we have a few minutes. We're gonna go sneak into the ring and do a quick little ride, make sure everything's feeling good. Apparently she's already bored with me. I'm excited to be back in my Wintec saddle with my thin line impact protection. And this is new. These are my performer ride breeches, brand new. I'm really excited for them. They're really comfortable. And it feels nice to be back in the saddle and feeling pretty good. Got my IRH helmet that I'm gonna wear during my ground demos too. So let's get at it.
So here's a little look at some warm-up practice. This was on Thursday. Basically, the show doesn't start until noon, so we had some time in the arena to just kind of play around and ride a little bit. So this was only my second time getting on Triv after Equine Affair back in Massachusetts several months ago. So this was really nice to get on my girl. And you'll see that little bit of a head tossing means she's feeling a little bit fresh. And even though she has a part boarder that rides her at home, so she is still like getting worked, but this was for me only the second time in a few months. But she's being a little bit head tossy and playful, so I decided to let my student hop on her. So I ended up letting Maya hop on her and gave her a little bit of a lesson on her. So this is Maya. And Maya actually ended up riding her in the thoroughbred breed demos for me as well, just to help let her move out her feet a little bit and make sure that I wasn't doing too much riding since I am 5 months prego at the time. So she got to do a little bit of playtime. And Arwin, back at the barn, got a clip job. So I had already clipped him to get all the disgusting mud mats off of him from being in the holding pens at the Ewing facility, because they lay down in the guck. But it looked really butchered and not a very good job. So Maya's really good at clipping and doing some nice straight lines. So she cleaned up the clip job to try to make it look more even and make it look a lot more presentable. And he was super good boy.
Wow,
and just stood super really nicely
line.
And quietly for it. So I was pretty proud
that's
of how patient he was and just how he stood so quietly. Nobody had to hold him. He could just stand really nicely. So his confidence has come up in a long way. And so this is the beginning stages of her getting him cleaned up. And he's just kind of relaxing and chilling out while she does that. While Mystique was getting a bath with her favorite Espana silk products from the girls. So being a gray, she definitely has to get bathed, and she can get quite a few stains on her, but we use the Espana silk all-natural grooming products, and they do a really great job, but they're also pretty nice on the horses. So we had a couple girls doing that. Florian and Leah were doing that. And then this is taking a look on the way over to the booth on Thursday morning. Gives you kind of a little bit of a look of the lay of the land and getting ready. And we're going to take a look at our booth. There's Jan behind the booth. So the team took turns manning the booth and did a really great job putting everything together. So really happy with that. And when I come back, this is the job that Maya had done with Arwin. So he's looking super fab and all ready for his first freestyle. So here we go into our first freestyle. So they screwed up our music. I shouldn't say they screwed up the music. They couldn't get the music to play on their player. So we ended up getting this other song that they chose like last minute. So I'm gonna show you guys this freestyle in its full entirety. It actually goes pretty good. So this was his first time doing this. He hadn't been in this ring before, and this is his Thursday freestyle performance as part of Equitainment. And so all of these obstacles are our own obstacles that we brought with us, so it's no surprise that he's used to them, but it's his first time in front of the crowd, And it's not a big crowd because it's Thursday. And so there you can see he walks off on the ground tie and he goes to leave. Not in a huge way I'm able to get him back, but he thought, oh, you know, I'd rather kind of peace out of here. And then it was a little bit awkward for me not having the right music, so I just kind of, I don't know what I'm doing a little bit of trotting, switching sides, and trying to figure it out as best I can, but just trying to get him relaxed a little bit with me too. You can see he's kind of looking at the crowd a little bit, like, what are they doing over there? And each day there were more people. Well, Saturday was the biggest day, so he got more used to it each day, which was fantastic. And so here with the flag and doing the blindfolding, he does that perfectly well, so I was really happy with that. And here I'm giving him positive reinforcement after not everything, but more things. And then by the end of each day, I wasn't using positive reinforcement so much during the routine, just after the lay down part, because he knew what he was supposed to do and he was able to do it. And then we go into our little side pass over the boxes. So he goes the one way, and then he comes back the other way to me. So we ended up swapping that out because there was a lady that was selling these affordable jumps and PAs, which she was called, and she had this treasure chest wall. So it kind of doubled as a wall that I could jump and a wall that he could side pass, and it was a little bit more stable. So that way he was less likely to knock it, or if he did touch it, it probably wasn't going to fall over, and we could put stuff inside of it. So I ended up using that for my last two demos and ended up buying it and bringing it home with me. So here up onto our little pedestal, and on the last day for the last demo, we had already packed up my pedestal. So I ended up using somebody else's pedestal, and even though it looked very different, it was a black one with a rubber top, he still went on it perfectly well, which was great. But overall, he did super fantastic. And I don't think the audience really knew there that I was trying to do pivot turns with him. But I'm going to have to work on those a little bit just to tidy them up a little bit more. And then when it came to the tarp, when we're at home, normally I just have him stand still and he lets me put things over him and around him. But because he didn't stand still for his ground tie with the umbrella, I thought, I'm not going to risk him running out. It's a really, really big arena and the doors are open, so I just keep a hold of his lead rope there just in case, because he's not really bothered. He's not bothered by what I'm doing with him at all. The energy is a little bit tense even though there's not that many people. And at home, I'm able to put the tarp over him and get him to lay down, but here you can see he's pretty tense. He's a little bit too nervous for it, so I end up just kind of abandoning that idea, and instead I'm going to push the tarp off of him. And for my other demos, my other freestyles that I do with him, I don't bother trying to do it under the tarp. I figure he's nervous enough in front of the crowd that for the rest of the demos for the week, I just do it without the tarp over him, so that way it's one less thing for him to worry about. And he seemed to enjoy that pretty nicely. So here I just kind of bring him into the center, and then I just do the lay down without having the tarp over him. So it's one less thing to be stressed about. He's already a little bit on edge from the crowd. So this is his first lay down off property, first lay down in front of a crowd. So it didn't take him too long, so I was pretty happy with that. There were not too many people in the crowd, so it wasn't too anxiety provoking for him. And then he's got this sit figured out pretty good and offers that. And that was his first demo, so I was really happy with that. So then later on Thursday, we had a clinic that I did on the anxious horse. And so this full video I will be posting in the Connection Club for anybody who's in there who wants to give it a watch. But basically I had Melissa riding Triv, and I had Arwin, and then I also had two students that joined me for the clinic with their own off-the-track thoroughbreds. And that one lady, she said before she walked into the clinic and her horse was like rearing and stuff like that, that she definitely 100% was not going to ride it. And by the end of the clinic, which was an hour long, he was able to be super relaxed, and she was riding him and sitting on him super calmly, and she was so thrilled. So that was really, really rewarding. So for me, it's always rewarding when the Calm Connection exercises, you know, they work so well and people always surprise themselves, because it's not me working with their horse, it's the owners working with their horses, and they're able to make such a big change in such a short amount of time. So that's super rewarding and really nice to see. And so we've got a few believers now in the crowd of, you know, that they work. And we were able to do it without breaking the horse into a sweat or having them have nervous poops. And, you know, interesting enough, there was another demo during the week of somebody doing an anxious horse clinic, but they weren't able to make progress. So that felt pretty special. So then later on that night, we had our rehearsal, which did not go super well, for the demonstration that we were going to be doing to Theater Equus. And then Guy McLean came on my tarp, and we just goofed around a little bit. But we did practice, so that was good. And then we do a lot of walks with the horses. So here's just a little clip of us doing a little walk. And that was our Thursday. And that took us into the next day, where now Arwin's getting his first bath. And I'm going to pull this video out as its own separate video, because he was not a fan of his bath to start with. And in the end, he ended up standing nice and quietly. But I'm going to show you guys that separately in a tips video. So stay tuned for that. And Mystique was enjoying her AccuHorse mat treatment, which is which has like these acupuncture points in it and helps relax the back. So Friday I didn't actually have any demos. I did have the thoroughbred breed demo, which Maya rode in, and I had the freestyle with Arwin, but otherwise this is my performance with Triv. I'm not going to show you the whole video here, but I just wanted to show you this little spook because of how dark they had the arena. And then when the person gets lit up, she's like, oh crap, there's somebody there. So they did fix that for the next night, but I just wanted to show you guys that little clip. And I'll be posting her performance in a different video for you guys, just so that way this one doesn't stay too long. And so that was a first for us, having a super dark arena with the spotlight. It was definitely intimidating. And I did tell them back, I was like, can you light up the arena just a little bit more? And then they added that blue lighting, which is kind of what they did for the second performance I did. But even still, the spotlight is so bright on me that I really couldn't see hardly at all where I was going. So definitely intimidating.
Hey, harmonizers! We're at the Horse World Expo in Pennsylvania, and we want to show you some of the fun we've been having.
So that's just a little clip of some of the people that hang around after their performances to kind of hang out, so that's always rewarding. And here's Maya riding Mystique in the thoroughbred breed demo, which brings us into Saturday, and this is now Arwin heading out for his trick demo. So to get there, we have to walk through the crowds of people to get to the round pen, and so I was pretty proud of him that he was able to walk by all those people and go in so nice and calmly and trust me to go in there. And I'm going to be posting this video on the Connection Club. So if you want to see the full video, that's where it will be. But I'll just show you a few little highlights here of some of the stuff that I was doing. So I was teaching tricks and kind of teaching about positive reinforcement and about getting your horse in calm alert, but also teaching about different tricks and different things. And Arwin was really good, and I had an opportunity to kind of practice my ground tie as well as a few other little things that were in the demo, and it was really nice. We had a really good crowd of people. This was Saturday, so it was the busiest day, and it was really well attended. And in a second here, I'm just going to let the sound play, and I will show you his lay down and his amazing sit. Like, he's really got it now. So take a look at this, because I am super proud of this little guy.
I'll just let him kind of explore that option. Okay. And then I'll help you out. Stay here quickly. Good boy. Do you have to be so awkward about it? If I'm not, I don't know. You're a little awkward. You're a little awkward. That's okay, bud. Don't be stodgy. Like, I just can't drop my booty, mommy. It's just too scary. Close. Just slow down, buddy. Don't scare yourself. Slow down. Don't scare yourself. Oh. Now faster. 1 million cookies coming your way. A million cookies coming your way. Good job. Good job. Oh, that's a good boy. He waited for me. That makes me very happy. Wow. Are you offering to sit? That's of high value. Wow, look at you. Wow. What a good boy. Up.
So I was super proud of my little Arwin, and then leading into the tonight's performance, so there's only two performances that we did with the Big Blue Tarp, because there's only two nights of Theater Equus, and you can see how they changed the lighting, and it was significantly better. I was able to see so much better, and I still think it looks super cool, the way they did the lighting, but definitely not anywhere near as intimidating as how it was the day before. So afterwards, Mystique and Arwin get their dinner, and so we give them the Omega Alpha supplement. So here they are getting their Biotic 8 added to their food. And my team is having a little bit of a party. They're pretty happy that they performed well, that they pulled off the tarp. So we continue to go and having fun. So then we wrap up the night by doing some autographs, and then Mystique.
So we're done for the night. We're all tired. Hi. Hi. Oops. Wait. Do over. Whoop. Mystique has figured out where her home is. Wait. Poop break. Mystique, where do you live, sweetie? Mystique, take us to your home. This is ultimate liberty. Go home to your bed. Okay. Where do you live, Mystique? Aw, there you go, little girl. Oh wait, we have a sleeping little boy. Oh, busted!
cuddling.
Mystique. So cute. So this is what we do at the end of the night. We give goodnight kisses.
So that brings us to the last day on Sunday, where I had a Liberty demo in the morning. So it was a Liberty demo with no tools, no chasing, no round pen. So I'm literally in the, like, I don't know what it is. It's a massive indoor arena with my horses. And I decided to let them both out because this is awesome. They get a chance to kind of run around and play and be goofy before having to go on the trailer for like 12 hours. So that was nice that they got to stretch their legs and run around. And so this video, again, will be on the Connection Club, the full demonstrations where I explain everything. And you could see that I'm just kind of sitting on the, you can kind of see me, that goes really fast, but I'm just sitting down chilling on the box there while they're just kind of running around and doing their own thing. And that's because the first step to doing Liberty with your horse with no tools is you need to observe your horse. You need to learn about your horse. And so we're just kind of observing the horses and figuring out where they're going, where they're not going, what their energy level's at. And I go into more detail during the demonstration, but all of this information helps us know what to do when we have the horses, once we're going to start to interact with them. And this was going to be Arwin's first time doing a demonstration. And so, kind of funny enough, they're running around and then they spot me and then they're like, oh, okay, we're good now, ready to work. So it's Friday morning at like 9 a.m. So there aren't a ton of people there. Saturday was definitely the busiest day, but I'm still pretty happy with the turnout that we had for people that decided to wake up early in the morning and come on Sunday. Sunday is definitely a quiet day at the expo for sure, but what a nice way for my horses to wrap up their experience. So we have a good chat about Liberty with no tools, and then I get ready to interact with him, but I didn't want to interact with both horses at the same time because it was going to be Arwin's first time doing Liberty. So I end up just doing one horse at a time. So I work with Mystique first and do a little bit of stuff with her and show some of the things that she's learned, and she has a pretty good time demoing a few different little things, and just kind of, it's fun because I tend to do mostly bridleless riding with her, so it's fun to play at Liberty and do a few little things. So that was a really awesome opportunity to get to play with her and just kind of show how you can put some of the ABCs together and start to ask your horse to do different things. But one of the key messages here was that the reason why I love playing at Liberty with no tools and in a big open space is because it stops you from becoming a jerk, essentially. You have to be a really good teacher for your horse. So if your horse doesn't do something that you want or they don't understand, you have to clarify for them. You can't just be more aggressive or more assertive. You can't just chase them around in a circle until they do what you want. You have to actually teach them what it is that you want them to do in a really polite way. And that's my favorite part about it. So here's a little clip of Arwin. He did super fantastic, and I was really proud. He didn't leave me not once during the Liberty demo, which I was super happy because it means that I was appropriate for him. It means I was engaging enough for him. It means that when he didn't understand things, that I was fair and that he felt he could do things. So I was really ecstatic with how things went, because I definitely want to try to do more Liberty with him, and hopefully we'll be doing Liberty for our freestyle. So here's a little look at his last freestyle performance on Sunday afternoon. So this was the last thing we did before we pieced out. We had the trailer already loaded with everything else, ready to go pretty much. And our US friends stayed behind to do the booth to the very end. And you can see we had the little box, my new wall that I got. So I was pretty excited about that. But all of his freestyles he did really, really well. So that's why I didn't want to put them all in here in full, just because they were very, very similar, and that would have been a lot of footage of a lot of the exact same stuff. And he just got more and more confident in front of the crowd each and every time. So he was doing really, really well. And this one, there's not as many people watching, so the pressure is a little bit off, but here you can see there's that different pedestal that he had to do. And he was a superstar, so I'm super thankful for that opportunity. And that's it, guys. That was our trip. We had so much fun. And thank you so much, guys, for watching. And make sure you look for those other videos that I'm going to be putting up of him having his bath and of Mystique's performances. I'll do those in separate ones for you guys. But we are all loaded up, and we made it home safely. Great trip. Thanks for watching, guys, and we will see you next time.